You okay?
Sure, I'm okay.
Everything comfortable?
Yeah, I'm comfortable.
Hey there, dear. I don't know where we're gonna sleep. Oh,
sleep in the van. We gotta sleep sometime.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I know it's gonna sound kind of weird, but I gotta play in a baseball game tomorrow.
What?
I gotta play in a baseball game tomorrow.
So many guns and au fait women in my life. Hey, brother, what are you fixing to do?
Search and destroy, sister. Search and destroy.
Search and destroy. What?
Pigs! Police pigs!
Police?
Cujo! You take first shift on the windows. Gabby, you cover the windows up. Yelena, you feed this army. And Fajita, come on, let's dispatch these men!
The house with an address they found in a parking ticket. They were gone, Charlie, but they'd been there. Their usual litter was all over the place.
And you say you've got the identifications of three of them, including the Hearst girl?
No, the other two, not the Hearst girl. A kid with a van who they grabbed and held overnight definitely saw the three of them. But so far, he says he can't identify the Hearst girl. Oh, yeah. Our L.A. people seem to think the kid is having a touch of misguided chivalry. He keeps saying how nice the second girl was. Anyway, L.A. is presuming the other girl's Patty.
Yeah, and I'm presuming that the whole thing is winding up out of our control.
Hey, is it true that there must be like people living in there? So what you got in there?
Just some wine and stuff.
Two vans parked behind house on north side of 84th Street. near Compton Boulevard.
All units, two vans found on 84th Street, possibly linked to SLA members. Intensify search in that area.
Ransom. Right? Communicate. Right. Coverage of power. Get that?
LAPD is checking out tips on three hideout houses in the area. Sandy's keeping a line open to L.A. in case you want to tell him something.
No, I wouldn't want L.A. to give it to me. It wouldn't stand for it. Not that I don't want him. I want him. Never wanted a bunch of fugitives more, but I want him alive. Especially her.
Charlie, Charlie, is she there?
Is Patty there with the rest of them?
Catherine, I don't know. There's just no way to know.
Somebody's got to know, Charlie. Somebody has got to know.
Charlie, they could have taken them without all this.
I'm going to try to move to a better vantage point. We'll keep you posted on further developments as they occur.
Like the psychologist said, they're begging to be killed.
I talked over with my father and he said I should call you guys. Do you think that was her in that house?
Three of the people have been identified by their dental chart. Not the Hearst girl yet.
I suppose you know, Mr. Bates, a lot of people are calling that shootout a massacre. Do you care to comment on that?
It was not a massacre. I've been telling the press all night that the people in that house were asked to come out 17 times, and 17 times they refused. Excuse me. Oh, thanks, Al.
L.A. just called. They identified another one. No, Not Patty. Camilla Hall. They found a half-written letter, charred but readable, addressed to her parents, warning them about us.
Oh, thanks. Won't help.
Gone. I know it won't help. Nothing will help but drink it.
My wife and I are appalled at the senseless massacre of those young people.
We were told by various law enforcement agencies all they wanted to do was to question these kids, that they wouldn't go in with guns blazing if they did find them. They lied to us. They slaughtered our sweet child.
Charlie, the Hearst girl wasn't in that house. She and the other two were nowhere near there.
We're going to meet with other parents. We are going to speak out for our dead children.
I say they're martyrs. The honored death of our struggle against the fascist insect.
Right.
One of them was my friend. When I first met her, she wasn't very political, but she was in the right place. There were many times I wanted to talk to her and ask her what the hell was going on with her in the SLA. Certainly, there were times when I felt they made serious mistakes and should have connected more with the people they were supposedly fighting for. But Angela, Camila, Nizmoon, and Ling, who became Jelena, Gabi, Zoya and Fahiza. Those women were among the first white women to fight so righteously for their beliefs and to die for what they believed.
Lucy Brawley with a B?
Yep. Yeah, I got her name. She's in the files at the office.
It's hard to believe that she's in touch with the Hearst girl and the other two, though.
Yeah.
My friend Angela was a truly revolutionary woman. Right. And the amazing thing is that she and her women comrades came from the same background as many of us here. They were white middle-class people with a lot of advantages who had gotten into the women's struggle and then generalized that struggle to include all people.
Yeah.
Yeah. To Pato, to Carmilla, to Tanya. Keep fighting! I'm with you! We're with you!
We know that the weathermen are taking credit for it. Yes, there's an act of contempt for the FBI. Oh, that too. Specifically me. Thank you.
There we are. File and forget.
I don't forget what?
Lucy Brawley.
You mean just because she stood up in public and advertised herself all over the place, we got to write her off as a suspect? Do I have to spell it out for you again? We're dealing with illogical people. They're messed up, neurotic, so just forget everything you've learned and go out and talk to Lucy Brawley.
Oh, Mr. Bates, these are the files you asked for.
Thank you.
I haven't seen Lucy Brawley in quite some time.
You weren't at the rally in Ho Chi Minh Park?
What rally, sir? You think they'll show up?
Gotta get her gear sorted out.
Scare you?
No.
Lady, I don't scare so easy.
Yeah, well, some people do. Doors we knocked on. So-called comrades who wouldn't help. Places we had to sleep. Tell them.
Well, one time under a porch. Another night in the abandoned tunnel.
All right, what we need now is a place to hide and somebody to take us there. I think I've got the guy, a friend of mine. Name's Kent.
How good a friend.
Good enough. I mean, he's part of it. Revolution? Revolution. Not war, baby. It's a war. And the people will win that war.
You okay?
She's strong. Tanya's tough.
Where are your friends?
Right out of the way.
Right, come on. Come on, get in. Let me see the handbag, Patty.
And I made it clear. No guns. That's music. Everything's gonna be all right, Pat. Why don't you try and get some rest? It's gonna be a long trip.
United Airlines flight 56 to Washington, D.C. is now boarding at gate 84.
It's a pleasure not to be thinking about that Hearst case for a day.
Agenda says we'll be talking about the Bureau inspection system. Got some things to say about that. Maybe a little rough, but it needs to be said.
Take it easy, Charlie. Maybe this isn't the time.
Two things I want to get off my chest. There's nothing personal in this about Joe Fredericks here. I know that running any kind of an internal affairs operation in any law enforcement agency has got to be a pain in the... at least a headache. However, the Bureau's system of internal inspection has just become too remote. And people in the field, I mean, rightly or wrongly, the people out there in the various offices like mine... they feel like they're being spied on by the shoe flies.
That's a cheap shot, Bates.
I don't mean it as a cheap shot. I really don't. We're here to discuss the inspection system, and I'm merely suggesting that right now it makes for a lack of confidence and low morale.
I'll tell you what I'm suggesting. The reason why morale is low in the Bureau is not because of any so-called problem with the way Joe Frederick is running inspection. It's because people are laughing at us, making fun of us all over the world, because Charlie Bates, the big critic, can't even catch Patty Hearst.
How long have you been in the Bureau? How many years, Lucas?
10 years.
Well, I've been doing my job for 32 years. 32 years of cases solved, and that's the reason why that they've kept me around here. And I'll solve this case, too. And I'll act the way that I've always acted, and I'll say what I damn well please in meetings like this. And when I leave, it won't be because of some guy like you crying in his beer, but because of that damn mandatory retirement. And until that time, the Patty Hearst case is mine!
This is Joan Shimada.
Joan Shimada. It's a real nice name.
Yeah. Too bad it's not really mine.
All right, don't you please do it again.
There's my friend, Pearl.
Find you! Find you! Find you! Fire, boys! Take cover! All right, the paint goon's over here. Return the fire!
Where am I?
All right.
And what's Pearl doing out there?
Practicing military drill. Friend, we've got ourselves one chicken general.
All right, sister, you watch yourself. Watch where you are. They're here. You feel them. Feel them. Smell them. They're all around you. They need to have it. What the fuck?
Oh, yeah, boys, take cover. Return it. Why the paint goes here? Return that fire. All right. This is good. On your belly. Eat it. All right, behind the deep. FBI. Come on. Murders in one. Move it. All right, sisters, all right. You got him in the crossfire. All right, let's go. Come on, the pig. There's the pig. Come on. Move it. All right, shoot him. All right. Pig, he's no good. Pig, the FBI pig. That's a fake pig.
I got information. Very important. Concerning the Hearst case.
Oh, another one of them.
I am them.
The Hearst are just sitting on the edge of their chairs waiting for you. And how would you have it? In small bills or large bills?
Never mind you. Just this. I personally know that a certain party drove Patricia Hearst across this country and stashed her away 6 months ago on a farm not too very far from here. Where does that grab?
Well, I've been grabbed before, sir. Your name?
They bring the dogs in now.
That's the Hearst girl, sent. They got it.
Very good. Terrific. Now you guys keep going out there. Remember, we're dealing with a bunch of pack rats. They leave their litter. Go through it all. Anything can be a lead.
Fingerprint our agents found at the Pennsylvania farmhouse. It belongs to one Wendy Yoshimura.
Hey. Okay, so it's Wendy, not Randy. But it's the beginning. Things are starting to connect.
Sure, I know Kent. I know a lot of people.
We have information that you visited Kent at a certain farmhouse 6 months ago.
Well, I might have.
You did, sir. Our information is quite positive. We need to know who else was there.
Hey,
guys are making me really nervous. I mean, going to cause parties and rallies are one thing, but...
We only want your help. No one is looking to file charges.
All right, when I visited the farm, Kent was there. And the girl, the Hearst girl. And those other two from the SLA. And a Japanese girl, a very pretty Japanese girl.
You mean Wendy Yoshimura?
Yoshimura? No, Shimada. She told me her name was Joan Shimada.
It's fine, son. Will you stop popping out of this tree?
All right. Now we have to get our act together. Come on, look at us. We have to think. We have to get organized. Give me the bakery list.
Oh, give me the bakery list! We have to learn to be opportunists.
We have to learn to exploit the enemy weakness. Now, here it is, brothers and sisters, in notes and diagrams, the way the People's Army offs a bank.
It used to feel like a People's Army.
It's still a People's Army.
No. Only when Angela and the others are alive. Are the people with us now?
They'll always be with us because our sisters were willing to die for them.
As long as the enemy is out there, struggle is going to go on.
Struggle will go on forever because we are part of a long history of revolutionary men.
Why stress revolutionary men?
Don't you undermine me! You know I didn't mean it that way!
I'm sick of your macho. It stinks! Sisters and brothers, this period of reorganizing is a little stressful. We're all impatient. The future is impatient.
I'm impatient. Hammered. Now you listen to me. Every time you undermine me, cause of some manics. You don't just hurt me, you hurt the cause itself.
Sacramento doesn't have a tangible SLA tie-in yet, but there are unverified reports that an Oriental woman drove one of the two switch cars. Now, this supposed other name for Wendy Yoshimura, Joan Shimada. Nobody's turned up anything yet?
Not yet, Charlie. Maybe she just made it up, used it that one time on the farm.
Maybe. Maybe it's just a coincidence that the driver in Sacramento looked Oriental. But let's try again. The name Joan Shimada, let's run it through the mill. Every piece of paper that we've touched in this investigation that might have a name on it, birth certificate, death notice, anything of record. Let's check it out again.
Me, Charlie Bradshaw.
Tom, I don't know how you do it. You caught me right in the middle of my gourmet dinner. What's up?
Joan Shimada's name turned up again. This time on a bill of sale for a car she bought in New Jersey. And then this Joan Shimada, whatever her name is, sold the car in turn to a girl known to be very close to Lucy Brawley.
You say you're looking for Lucy and Jess?
That's right.
I wouldn't know where they are. I'm only their uncle. You really think they're involved in the Hearst case?
Well, I think they might be, yeah. But there's one thing I know for a fact. That Hearst girl is in more and more danger every day. And anybody that can remotely help her should step forward.
You really care about that, Mr. Bates? Seems to me the Attorney General has already labeled her a common criminal.
Well, of course I care. Whatever she might be right now, temporarily, I think I know how she got that way. You might know how your two nieces and your nephew got the way that they are.
Jess, used to come around, help me oil the equipment. It's the kind of kid he is. Loves to work with his hands.
there's one young fellow who'll never go hungry. Wherever he is, he'll find himself a job. Maybe with a hammer, maybe with a paintbrush. Outdoor work, that's healthy. I want that very much, Mr. Bates. For all three of them to stay healthy.
Well, appreciate your help. Thank you very much. He went as far as he could go.
Yeah, and then some.
Early tomorrow, check out every construction subcontractor in the Bay Area. Especially those that are using Berkeley street people for cheap labor.
Right.
Just Broly in another dead end.
Assume that the Pasita Street house is our primary target. It would seem that Lucy Brawley is living there along with the other Brawley girl, which is the one we've linked to Yoshimura. So let's just play it cozy and see who else goes in now that house. And the other one too, of course, the one on Moore Street.
What do you think? Another fishing expedition?
Who knows? Did you have much sleep last night?
Huh. Woke up at 4 o'clock this morning. Couldn't wait to get back to Pasita Street, huh?
And a chip front tooth.
Situation room? Let me speak to the chief. Have this shit yet for me, all right?
Situation room.
Hello, is Jack there?
Now, we don't know if we've hooked one of our big fish or not. It could be just a look-alike. I'll tell you something. If we mess up this time,
we're going to take our lumps again. Now, surveillance says that he jogged today. Well, hopefully he'll do the same thing tomorrow. And if he does, that's when I want to take him. I want him out of the house, tired and unarmed. I don't want the same thing to happen here that happened in Watts. Just keep your cool. Make no moves unless you hear from me. Be careful what you say on your mics. I think the TV and press people are monitoring our radio calls.
All units in position and standing by.
Checkpoint 7, in a clear.
Truck stopping in vicinity.
I see our friend from yesterday.
How much you want for a filet?
Oh, it's $1.50 for that one.
$3? I'll
give you two, Sam.
$2 is going to take.
You're
that's
wrong.
All right.
Give me
a
sample.
Okay, great.
No, give me this one.
You want this one here?
Yeah.
I'll give you this one.
A seafood item.
I have a
good one. That certain possible fish.
Just bought one. Point 7, still clear.
A friend has a friend. And I'm betting it's the blonde we're looking for. She must have a wig on.
Observe. Don't interfere.
Point 3 has been reached and passed. They've reached the outer perimeter. We're losing visual contact. Is there a change in the drill?
No change. Repeat. No change.
15 minutes out. They should be back in 15 minutes and good and tired.
Reached and passed.
Number one, here they come.
Execute the plan. Repeat, execute the plan.
Help me, I'm
go! Come on, Robert!
Here for it. Get some people moving. Hit the house on Moore Street.
Situation room.
Wonderful.
I'll tell him. Mr. Bates, she's on her way up in the prisoner's elevator. Congratulations.
Charles Bates, Miss Hearst. I rather imagine that if you're glad that this is all over.
Get a fingerprint and photograph. Let her make one phone call.
September 5th, 1978, Charles Bates, now retired, wrote to the U.S. Attorney General recommending that Patricia Hearst be released from prison based on time already served. Patricia Hearst was brought to trial on February 4th, 1976 in the Federal District Court, San Francisco, California. She was found guilty and finally sentenced on September 24, 1976, to 7 years imprisonment. On January 29, 1979, President Carter commuted her sentence to time served. Patricia Hearst was released from the Federal Correctional Institution at Pleasanton, California, on February 1, 1979.